Hello, my fellow Spartans. So today we will be discussing about Teen Patti, aka Flash variations. On request of my fellow Spartans, we will be making more videos on such variations. Today we will discuss about discard one card and assume one card variation. So stay tuned. So, variation I would like to discuss about is discard one card. In this variation, every player is provided with four cards, and all the players can see when they see their cards, they can discard any one of the cards to make their best play. In this variation, mainly the probability, there is no jokers, there is no flipping jokers also, and the player play by their hands. One of the tips: usually people do get a pair or even a color in this kind of a game. So play accordingly, play safe. Now you will be dealing some hands to make you understand it better. Let's go. Each player can discard one card in this game in order to make the best play. So we'll be opening up the cards now in order to understand that what would be your best play when you are playing this game. Also, one more thing, if you have not seen the video on what is the hierarchy of winning hands, then please do check out the same in the I button above, as well as the link is in the description below. So let's discuss about these four hands. Here we have a four of diamonds, a four of spades, a king of diamonds, and a five of diamonds. Now you may think that a pair of four would be a better hand in this. However, if you remove this four of spades from this, then you have the best hand, that is a five of diamonds, a king of diamonds, and a four of diamonds, which means a color of king. Now let's see the other hand. A six of diamonds, a seven of diamonds, a two of clubs, and a spade of jack. In this is not a very good hand. The best you can take is the highest card can be the J. So here we would take highest card as J and discard the two. Now let's see the third hand. A club of eight, a spade of queen, a heart of eight, and a heart of ace. Here, even though you have two hearts, you have one club, you have one spade, but the best hand in this would be to discard this queen and make ace as the second supporting card, and it's an eight pair with a supporting of an ace. Now let's see the fourth hand. A queen of clubs, a king of hearts, a seven of clubs, and a ten of clubs. Here also, it is very interesting that you discard the king of hearts and you make the best pair as queen of clubs, seven of clubs, and ten of clubs. So now we have all our four hands with us. Now we can decide which hand would win amongst all. Here, the hand which is the best hand in amongst these is the king of diamonds. This hand would win since it is a color of king. This hand has the color of queen. So as you know, as per the hierarchy, this hand would win. I hope you understood this variation pretty well. Now let's play the assume third card variation. One card to each player would be distributed. One card would be common for all, and the third card is to be assumed by you. Make sure you know the hierarchy of suit which is to be taken and given the preference as per the hierarchy wise. So the spade would come at the top, then followed by a heart, then diamond, and then club. So let's distribute the cards. Let's get going. Let's see what the four hands spans out. So this is the common card which is going to be there for each and every of the player which they have to fit in. So now let's see what hand everyone has. So we have 10 of hearts, a spade of queen, a diamond of king, and a queen of hearts. Let's see what the fourth and the common card is. Wow. So we have a diamond of queen as the joker, or as not as the joker, but as the common card. So now everyone has to fit this queen in their respective hands, and then they can assume the third card. So let's take an example. He fits in, the first hand fits in. It's a 10JQ sequence which he has. So basically, but it's an impure sequence. Now the second hand puts in, he or she has a trail of queen. Now we'll come back to a very important point later on. The third hand, a better hand than the first hand. This hand has queen, king, and ace as the pure sequence, because all of them would be of the diamonds. You would assume the third card as ace of diamonds. Now the fourth hand would be again the trail of queen. So let's, to simplify further, let's pack these two hands, as these hands would not win, and see amongst who would win in these two hands. Now, as I told you that we have to go as per the suit hierarchy. So what is the hierarchy? The spade comes as the top, followed by hearts, followed by diamonds, and then the club at the bottom. So this is a classic example wherein we have spade, we have a heart, and we have a diamond. Now, since this hand has the spade of queen and this hand has the heart of queen, so if there's a showdown amongst these two, the pot will not split. The show goes down would also not be there in this case. This hand would win in this particular game, because in this game the hierarchy of the suit is followed. So the queen of spade would win over the queen of hearts. Thank you for watching. I hope you like this video and it gives you wing to understand the teen patti variations in a better format, in a better manner. Make sure to hit the like button and subscribe to our channel and grow our Spartan community. Signing off, this is Kanish Agarwal. See you at the next video.